We are at the experimental field for International Flavors and Fragrances Laboratory Monique Remy. Before you actually get your fragrance in a bottle, your fragrance actually starts here in a crop, right? And so here we have seeds and they're being cultivated in fields. And why do we need an experimental field, Claire? Why an experimental field at a fragrance place?
Well, we need it. It's so important because we have an internal R&D team at IFF LMR, and the labs are about 10 minutes away from here, driving. So our scientists, our agronomists, they come here, they work with Sebastian, the farmer here, and they can study together new innovation, new ways to harvest the plant, new mechanization, agricultural practices, everything to make the plant better, smell better, better yield, et cetera.
I see. So producing a fine fragrance is really tough, and there's a lot of factors to consider. One of the things that caught my ear is that you were saying that you have chemists, but you also have people called agronomists, which focus on agriculture.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
So part of producing a really good fine fragrance is making sure that you're cultivating it right.
Exactly, totally. And so we cultivate everything all around the world, but here we experiment at a small scale, everything that we will then implant at a larger scale in many different countries, depending on the flowers or the plants.
Okay, so it's tested here, and then it gets implemented around the world. Where do you have crops, and what type of crops do you have?
Yeah, so we have everything everywhere. We have roses in Turkey, we have vetiver in Haiti, we have jasmine in India, patchouli in Indonesia, and many more.
Do you get to go to all those places just out of curiosity?
Well, it's yes, I get to go there.
You're spoiled. Wow, you're so lucky. I would love to go to all those places.
No, yeah, so it's beautiful, and we always try to find new types of ingredients, so perfumers can be even more creative and have more options.
So there's an exploratory part of the process too, where you go out and you try to find new ingredients.
Exactly.
Okay, and for the ingredients that you have, you're like optimizing and fine-tuning so that you can always get the best scent.
Exactly. Optimization is really the right word.
Okay.
Something that exists already, but we can make it better.
Awesome.
In terms of the smell, in terms of the yield.
Right. And International Flavors and Fragrances is really known for this, right? I've been hearing from people in Grasse. In fact, I just talked to a woman today. Her company was 1,000 Flowers, and she said she sourced a lot of her raw materials from you guys.
Yes, LMR, IFF LMR is one of the biggest natural extract supplier, producer in the world. So we're very famous for our very high quality ingredients.
Well, I feel very lucky to be here, and I'm so glad that you guys can join me today. Can you give us some examples of how the cultivation process affects maybe the scent?
Yes, for instance, right now our R&D team is studying a lot geranium.
Yes,
and they're realizing, for instance, if you stop watering the plant a little bit before the harvest, it's going to give a better yield.
Ooh.
So it's like us, sometimes we work better under pressure.
Right.
Well, geranium,
that's me.
It's the same.
Maybe I'm in geranium then. That's my signature flower.
Yeah.
Can you give me an example of how much yield you get for how much crop?
So it depends on every plant. Every flowers, every plant gonna have a better yield. Some they have very low yield, like orris, for instance. That's why it's gonna be very expensive. Some other plants, like lavandine, gonna have a very high yield. So it's a bit cheaper because you need less.
Right, and this is really important because one of you out there had asked me earlier today, how does the flower affect the price, or like what makes something expensive? And so one of them you're saying is yield.
Yeah, yield. And when you think about orris, which is one of the most expensive extracts, natural extract.
I didn't know that.
Yes. Why? Because first, orris needs to be 3 years in the soil to really grow. So you wait 3 years, and then once you harvest it, it has to be 3 years in a room to dry. So 6 years.
Wow.
Just before you extract it. So that's why it's very expensive.
That's one heck of a waiting process.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do we have here?
So here we're in the greenhouse, which is great during the winter and for our farmer to really save the plant and study.
Okay.
And here you see a lot of different type of geranium, which are also called pelargonium, actually. Pelargonium is the official,
the official
name.
Okay.
So you see a lot of different type, and you see, so if you, for instance, do that on one of these and you smell.
Okay, so pinch like yeah, you a little just bit like pinch it. Okay.
And you can smell it. You see, it's a little bit citrusy.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, and if we try another one, like let's try that one. If you do the same thing with another finger.
Okay. So I'm gonna pinch this one over here. Yeah. Sorry, plant. We're gonna pinch you. All right.
And smell the difference. It's very minty.
Oh my goodness. Okay. So what just happened? And I wish there was smell-o-vision on this, but this one was very citrusy. So if I smell this, my hands smell a little like geranium, but with a little bit of citrus. And then when I did this one, it smells like mint. And so it's two different, would you say, smell profiles from the same plant?
It's the same plant, it's just different species.
Different species,
and they all smell different. I mean, you could do, then we don't have enough fingers, but you could do the same exercise with all of them, and that's why the R&D team is studying right now. Studying the, extracting them, seeing is it interesting? When you extract it, do you still get that citrusy feel or not? Does it have a good yield? Is it very different from what we use already? So trying to find new things.
I didn't realize that there were so many variations.
Yeah.
And so that's something that fine fragrancers have to consider. Not only the that it's geranium or a type of plant, but it's also the species that influences it.
Exactly, many species. Rose, it's the same, the Damascena, the Centifolia. They're two different species, two different origins.
Right, and just so you guys know, the difference, I mean, it blew my mind. I knew that they were both geranium, but it is very different in the actual scent between these two species. So that's something that's really interesting to know.
Mm-hmm. So that's our geranium. Okay. And here, for instance, we have vetiver.
Okay, so this is going to be our last example, and then we're going to take a time out for a while. Yeah.
Just vetiver here, they just got cut. Usually they're very, very high.
Okay.
But this is just for R&D.
So it's a vetiver after a haircut.
After a haircut. But for vetiver, anyway, what we use is the roots. So we cut the roots.
I had no idea. Yeah. So it's not even the top of this, it's the roots that you're using.
It's the roots, and usually they go very, very deep in the soil.
Okay. If I pick it and smell it, will I be able to smell it or not
you
really?
You might not be able to smell much because they need to dry and to be clean, but you can...
Okay.
It's not going to smell much. It's going to smell very earthy.
Yeah, it smells mostly earthy. Yeah. Okay.
So here our team is studying, see the roots, and they found that little tricky way to study them without putting it in the soil. But that's a little trick.
Right. Wow, that's really fascinating. So we're going to take a little break right here. I think we have one question before we go. So we have Fred who has a question. Fred says, does IFF share their lessons learned with other flower growers around the world? So what's trade secret and what's up for just general knowledge here?
Well, yeah, what we learn here, then we exchange everything we've learned with the farmers we work with all over the world. So the idea is really to always exchange the knowledge and teach them the better agricultural practices.
Nice.
So all the farmers that we buy the flowers from, they can have better practices and everyone's happier.
Okay, because that helps improve things, for example, like sustainability, right? The less yield that you're able to use, the more sustainable it is.
Yeah, and also like if a farmer spends less time working on plants and has a better yield for him, it means more money, more time to work on other things.
I see.
So it's also sustainable in a human way for all our partners.
Right, that's wonderful. Wow, well this is such a treat. What we'll be doing is coming off and on again, and I'll be sharing this experience as I'm experiencing it. So stay tuned, we're going to be doing some more lives. So just keep an eye out for when you see our live come out. And that is about it for right now. Does anybody have any questions before we head out? Well, in that case, what we'll do is save your questions, and when we pop back on, you can ask them. We have Claire LeBlond here, and she is giving us the tour of IFF International Flavors and Fragrances. We are visiting their laboratory, Monique Remy, and exploring natural raw materials for fragrances. So we'll catch up with you guys again soon. Take care. Bye.
Bye-bye.